Good afternoon to everyone. As already said by Professor, that today presentation will be on polymer modified bitumen, quality, specifications, usage, and guidelines of using such type of new materials for road construction. We are aware about the bitumen binder, which is a common binder for road construction purpose. I would also, in our country, then road tar was used for road construction purpose, but the drawback of the road tar was the fast oxidation of the material. That's why the roads were not long lasting, as the case with bitumen roads. So slowly bitumen has replaced road tars, and after 1956 only bitumen from the refineries was being used for such type of flexible pavement construction. The other materials along with the bitumen, we should also be aware about those. These are bitumen emulsions and cutback bitumen. But all these four type of materials binder does not serve the purpose of some special locations. For general purpose, they are all right. But when we talk about the special locations, for example, intersections, this bus stops, airfields, roundabouts, then some extra forces are there, extra loading are there, extra action of the forces are there. For that purpose, we need special binders. These special binders are named as modified bitumen. These modified bitumen can be polymer modified bitumen, crumb rubber modified bitumen, and waste plastic modified binders, that is WPMB. What are the limitations of conventional bitumen that we are thinking today about the modified binders? These limitations are: binders bitumen are brittle at low temperature. So because in our country there are diverse climatic conditions, varying climatic conditions, so when climatic conditions temperature is as low as minus 20 degrees Celsius at heights, then these roads become brittle and cracks develop. At the same time, the bitumen becomes soft in hot climatic conditions. We know our northern region, the climatic condition is very hot. In summer days, temperature, pavement temperature I am talking, pavement temperature goes up to 70 degrees Celsius, whereas the atmospheric temperature may be 50, may be 46, 47, but pavement temperature further go high. So in that condition, bitumen binder become soft, and depressions and rutting is the prominent phenomena in such type of climatic condition. High temperature susceptibility means it is binder is very susceptible to temperature. It changes with low temperature, it changes with high temperature, and for moderate climatic condition it behaves differently. It is also susceptible to viscoelastic deformation, that is rutting. In some part of our country, channelized traffic is there. Due to the channelized traffic, the rutting is the prominent phenomena and deformation occurs due to rutting phenomena. Fatigue failure, that is due to cracking at low temperature. And lastly, sometimes there is a poor adhesion between aggregate and bitumen binder. So with all these limitations, we are always in search of some new materials, some modified type of materials. Now bitumen is generally produced by the traditional methods of vacuum reduction and air blowing of petroleum crude, and it cannot meet all the requirement of increasing severe service conditions. Namely, roads with high traffic intensity, for example, expressways, highways, where the traffic loading and traffic intensity is very high. Then road locations subjected to heavy traffic stress, bus stops, intersections, roundabouts, and bridge decks also. Over the bridge decks, we need special materials, either mastic or polymer modified binders. Then reflection cracking in bituminous overlay over cracked concrete pavement. Here I would like to stress upon, when we talk about the cement concrete road, that on cement concrete road, if cracks, then there is no remedy for that. We have to give an overlay of bituminous binders, that is with modified binder, not with the conventional binder. Then urban roads where reduced surfacing thickness is desired. As we know, in our city roads, frequent failure of road is there. After every monsoon, road goes away, aggregate chipping go away, and then we need overlaying. So with the overlaying, every year the road height is increased, thickness is every year is increased. So if we used, instead of conventional bitumen, if we use modified binders, then reduced thickness, surfacing thickness will work for the same time period when we talk about the conventional roads. Fifth number is surfacing for low temperature snowbound areas. In snowbound areas, we need flexible surface. Brittle surface will crack. So conventional binder are very brittle in low temperature area, but polymer modified binders give flexibility, give elasticity to the binder. Then airfield surfacing where high stiffness and thermal stability is required. We know that with the tire friction of the aircraft, very high heat is generated, and due to this high heat, stiffness of the binder loses and thermal degradation of the binder is there. So to overcome such type of problem, modified binders have high stiffness, they are more thermally stable, that's why they can be used for airfield surfacings. Typical problem faced in our country, some of these I will explain. Again, heavy channelized traffic to be carried in the tropical and subtropical region with high tire pressure of the truck. So in such type of condition, we need ability to resist permanent deformation and rutting. Then higher potential for developing fatigue cracking due to repeated load. When the axle load is repeated again and again on a surface, then we need to recover the surface after the load go away. But in case of conventional binder, recovery is not there because of the less elasticity, less flexibility. But in case of modified binder, this recovery is there as fast as the load goes away from the pavement. Higher potential for thermal cracking at site where pavement are subjected to sub-zero temperature for extended period. Due to weather conditions, for long time, when sub-zero temperature exists in Himalayas region at high altitude, then we need to arrest thermal cracking of the flexible pavement. So severe overloading, extreme variation in climatic condition existing in our country, it is not in our hand because climatic condition are given by the nature. We cannot control. Sometimes thunderstorms are there, high rainfall is there, hot climatic condition are there. Severe overloading, it is a legal problem. Policing is being done. But even then, in our country, overloading cannot be checked regularly. So if we check in one part of country due to policing, it is failed in other part of country. So when these factors are not in our hand And due to these factors, premature cracking of pavement, they are rutting and shoving is there. Then what we can do? Only we can develop the best material to resist such type of problems. So this is bleeding, example of the bleeding and raveling on the road. When we talk about the bitumen binder, there are penetration grade binder used. These are three types: 80-100 for general purpose road construction and maintenance, 60-70 for roads and airfield, 30-40 for coastal areas. do we know what is 60-70? Yeah, it is a penetration number lies between 60 and 70 somewhere. So that grade will be called 60-70 penetration grade. But nowadays, instead of penetration grade, we have switched over to viscosity grade, VG10, VG20, VG30, VG40. These are the, each grade is equivalent to some penetration number, penetration grade again. So we cannot forget about our old fashion of grading bitumen, that is penetration grade nomenclature. So here are four grades available in our IS 73 grade code of practice for bitumen: VG10, VG20, VG30, VG40. Depending upon their stiffness and hardness, we have to know different construction temperatures for different operations. For example, for spraying or laying of the mix or production of the mix, the temperature will be different for four different grades. For mixing purpose, temperature is also varying. For example, for VG10, it is in the range of 140 to 160 degrees Celsius. But when we talk about VG40, which is a harder grade binder, we have to go for mixing for a higher temperature, that is 160 to 175 degrees Celsius. Similarly, for rolling operation, the temperatures are different depending upon the VG grade. Whatever VG grade is being used, the temperature of different operations will depend on that. Now, viscosity grade paving bitumen quality and usage guidelines. Before we need to know about polymer modified binder, we should be well aware about the VG grade binders. So these are some properties of VG grade binder: VG10, 20, 30, 40. There are several tests. The main test is the viscosity. Viscosity of bitumen is being done at two different temperatures. One is the 60 degrees Celsius and another is the 135 degrees Celsius. 60 degrees Celsius correlates our pavement temperature and 135 for the construction operation. So these two temperature viscosity parameters are to be known if we want to do proper construction with proper grade of binder. Third property is the flash point. Why do we carry out the flash point? For the safety purpose, to know up to what temperature these type of binders are safe to use. So after flash point, there is a fire point. So if one material will cross it flash point, it may catch fire. So due to that safety reason, it is very important to know flash point of the binders. Then solubility in trichloroethylene in percentage, it should be 99% soluble in trichloroethylene solution, solvent. Then penetration, it is very, very empirical property. Since last many years, we are doing it to know the penetration number, penetration grade of the binder. But again, it is related to high volume traffic and low volume traffic. If we want to bitumen for high volume traffic, then the penetration number minimum should be 80 for VG10, 60 for VG20, 50 for VG30 and 40 for VG40. If you want to use the same binder for low traffic volume, then the minimum penetration numbers are given in this table. So next is the softening point. Similarly, softening point is also an empirical property. Since last many years we are doing softening point, and we are designated our binder based on the softening point also. So minimum 40 and maximum 50. So in this range we should have at least our softening point. Test on residue from thin film moment test. It is a very simple test. We heat bitumen at 163 degrees Celsius in an oven for more than 5 hours. Then we try to find out the viscosity at 60 degrees Celsius. We know the viscosity at 60 degrees Celsius, that is absolute viscosity in this table at point number 1, serial number 1. So the ratio before thin film oven test and after thin film oven test, ratio of the viscosity should be known, and it should be maximum 4 in all case of all 4 types of binder. Ductility at 25 degrees Celsius, it is also one of the important parameter we should know. Ductility after thin film oven test. Before thin film oven test, there is no need to do ductility, but after this test, we need to know. Now, what is the solution of all the problems I have discussed so far in our country due to the quality of the viscosity grade bitumen? So the solution lies in the use of polymer modified bitumen. So from here, really I will talk about the, this was the background why we need polymer modified bitumen. Now, what are the polymers? What is this terminology, polymer? So when very small chemical units, we call it monomer, they are joined together by some chemical reaction, by some polymerization method, it gives very high molecular weight polymers. So monomers, for example, is styrene. So when we polymerize styrene, we will get polystyrene. Butadiene, polybutadiene. Ethylene, polyethylene. So we need to polymerize the monomers. So such type of materials are known as polymers. Now, what are the classification of polymers being used for modification of bitumen? It is not that every polymer will modify the bitumen. There is some special class that is known as thermoplastic type of polymer. When we heat bitumen, what happens? When we heat it up to a certain temperature, let us say 100 degree, 150 degree, what will happen to bitumen? It will get soft, it will get liquefy, it will come in the liquid state. And when we leave it for natural cooling, again it gets solidify. So this type of property is known as thermoplastic. Similar type of, there are polymers, when we heat it, it gets softened, it gets melts, and when we leave it for natural cooling, these polymers get solidify. So because of the similarity in the nature of bitumen and polymer, thermoplastic type of polymer, we are able to mix these type of polymers with bitumen. So examples I have given: low density polyethylene, ethylene vinyl acetate, ethylene butyl acrylate. So these are the some thermoplastic type of polymers which used for modification of bitumen. What is modified bitumen? Before this, I'll show you other examples of thermoplastic: styrene butadiene rubber, styrene butadiene styrene, polyisoprene, chloroprene, polybutadiene, ethylene terpolymer, natural rubber and waste tire rubber. These are the polymers which can be used for modification purpose. Another type is thermoset. Thermoset, I mean to say, when I will heat the polymer, it will cross link, it will cure, and it will set forever. It will never come back with it in original form. So such type of polymers are known as thermosets. Example is epoxy resin. But such type of polymer are not successful for modification of bitumen. Only thermoplastic type in nature. Those should be added to bitumen. So once I have modified bitumen in my hand, with modified bitumen made with polymer, a very large molecular weight compounds, after polymerization, it is come in the form of modified bitumen. So this is known as modified bitumen. So once I have rubber or polymer modified bitumen in my hand, what should be the properties of such type of binders? When we add polymer, a sufficient increase in viscosity happens. Immediately viscosity will improve, and that will prevent plastic deformation of the rods. Increase in flexibility and elasticity of binder will take place, and at low temperature this property is to delay the crack formation and loss of chipping. So these two properties are taken care with the help of polymer modified bitumen. High thermostability. When I have already talked about the tire friction, so when aircraft is landing or taking off, then there is a, due to tire friction, high heat is generated, and due to that heat, pavement will destroy. But higher thermostability in case of modified binder, improved homogeneity and aging resistance. Why aging resistance? Aging of the road will improve, because when polymers are produced in the industry, antioxidants are added. Some antioxidants, some percentage is added due to in the process of polymerization. So already antioxidants are there in the polymer. They take care of oxidation and hardening of the binder during mixing, during construction operations, laying, and during service life. Now, when we talk about the development of polymer modified binder in the laboratory, then we should know the melting behavior of a polymer. What is the melting temperature, liquefying temperature of a polymer in the laboratory? It varies from polymer to polymer. For example, in case of low density polyethylene, it melts around 114 degrees Celsius. Ethylene vinyl acetate, it melts around 90 degrees Celsius. And this is alvaloy, it is a imported polymer, it melts around 60 degrees Celsius, even lower than 90 degrees. Second parameter we should know about the degradation behavior or decomposition of the polymer. At what temperature it will get decomposed? So in all these cases, most of the thermoplastic, they are stable, thermally stable up to 250 degrees Celsius, and nothing happen when we talk about the degradation of those polymers. So these are some of the modifiers I have shown through this diagram. Plastic, polymer, rubber, natural rubber, crumb rubber, tire crumb rubber, and thermoplastic type of polymers for as a modifier. Now, what machinery we require when we talk about the polymer modified binder? What happened there? Can you see this picture is there? Okay. This side. Okay, fine. That side also, this side also, both sides it will come. So when we talk about the machinery, we require a high shear mixer for digestion of polymer into bituminous phase. So from one side bitumen, another side polymer will come, and a motor of 15 to 20 horsepower with RPM varying 200 to 3000 RPM. Why this variability is there, 200 to 3000 RPM? Because this will take care of blending of various type of polymers one by one. So we have to develop such type of machinery that it should take care whatever polymer we add, it get digested, it get dispersed, it get melt, and we get a homogeneous blend of polymer modified binder. Temperature of bitumen generally kept 160 degree, below 160 degree when we talk about the polymer modified binder, but in some cases we have to go up to 170 to 180 degree Celsius when polymer does not get mixed properly. Then we have to increase the blending temperature or mixing temperature. So one, I have product modified binder in my hand. What should be its properties? It should be compatible with bitumen. Generally what happens when we add plastic, rubber or a polymer in hot molten condition of bitumen, it gets dispersed and we see a single phase, homogeneous phase. But when it cool down, either it come on the surface or it gets settled down. So it is not compatible with bitumen. So that type of modified binder is of our no use. So modified binder should be homogeneous phase, modifier should be compatible with bitumen. It should resist degradation of bitumen at mixing temperature. At hot mix plant, when we produce the bitumen mix, that time temperature goes up to 160 degree Celsius. So at 160 degree Celsius, polymer or any other material, rubber or plastic, it should not degrade at the mixing temperature in hot mix plant. Then third thing, it should be capable of being processed by conventional mixing. It should also maintain premium properties during storage, application and in service. Here I mean to say that in the entire life of the road, during storage of the binder, during its application for the road construction purpose, their properties should not be lost. Whatever properties we have achieved in case of polymer modified binder after its production, those properties should be retained. And lastly, it should be cost effective on a life cycle cost basis. When we add something to bitumen, the initial cost will go high because every material has its own cost. But in the entire life cycle of a road life, the cost effectiveness should be there. Suppose we have designed a road for 15 years and every 5 years we need a renewal coat for maintenance purpose. But when we use polymer modified bitumen, at least we can save one renewal coat. So during 15 years of life, instead of 3 renewal coat for maintenance, only 2 will be enough. So we are compensating the initial high cost of modified binder in such a way. What are the advantages of PMB over conventional bitumen? It is its lower susceptibility to daily and seasonal temperature variations. In Rajasthan, we are aware that the daytime temperature is very high, but night time the temperature goes down. So daily variation temperature is there. In some part of our country, seasonal variation temperatures are there. So binder should not be, polymer modified binder should not change their property with the daily temperature variation and the seasonal temperature variation. High resistance to deformation at elevated pavement temperature means in northern climatic conditions where the pavement temperature, atmospheric temperature is very high, the road should not deform. better aging resistant and higher fatigue life of the mixes, so the our roads will serve the purpose for which whatever design life is there, we have designed for them, so they should complete their life. Better adhesion between aggregate and binder. Some polymers, they act as the adhesives also between aggregate and binder phase. It should also prevent cracking and reflective cracking. We know that when cement concrete road, cracks are there. Even if we put the conventional bitumen road over the cracked concrete road, the crack reflection will come after some time. But with the help of polymer modified binder, the crack reflection phenomena is delayed. Overall improvement in performance in extreme climatic condition and under heavy traffic load conditions is the benefit of using polymer modified binders. When we talk about the application of polymer and rubber modified binder, it cannot be used everywhere for general purpose road construction, for city roads, no need, because they are initially their cost is high. So special applications are, these can be used as stress absorbing membrane, stress absorbing membrane interlayer, as a renewal course, as a part of maintenance, and in high traffic load, where in case of highways and airfield pavements, special locations like roundabouts, bus stops and intersections. So these are the some special locations where these type of binders are recommended. Now when we talk about the performance of PMB, some lab experiments are necessary. We cannot go directly taking a product to the field without testing in the laboratory. So we should know what are the performance of a polymer modified bitumen in the laboratory. For that purpose, I have shown some slides included in my presentation. One is the elastic recovery. So elastic recovery is a very simple test. It can be done in the ductility test machine, but the mold of the elastic recovery is slightly different from the ductility mold. Sides are different only, otherwise the actual mold is the same. So in this case, in case when we test ductility, we fix one end of the binder and we pull the machine, second end of the binder, and we pull it till it breaks. First it comes into the shape of a thread and then it breaks. So that reading is known as ductility, when the thread breaks at a particular temperature. But in case of elastic recovery, there is a slight modification in the test. We pull the specimen up to 10 cm only. Then we cut the thread at midpoint. We leave it for 1 hour at 15 degrees Celsius in the machine itself. Then what happens? The two end of the specimen of the binder, it shrinks like this. So a gap is created between these two ends. After 1 hour, we join two ends and we see how much gap was created due to the shrinkage, due to the recovery of the binder. So suppose my initial reading is fixed, that is 10. I will pull the specimen up to 10 centimeter only. My second reading is 5. After 1 hour, I'll join two ends and the reading comes to the 5. So what is the elastic recovery? How much it has recovered? 10 minus 5 divided by 10, not x. X is wrong here. I want to correct it. 10 minus 5 divided by 10 into 100. So how much is this? 50%? So elastic recovery is 50%. I have shown this calculation here. This is the dimension of the elastic recovery mold, slightly different from the ductility mold. here I have shown the calculation in the detail. So here 10 minus 5 divided by 10 into 100, it comes out 50%. Then another important test is the separation test. When I add a material in bitumen, polymer, rubber, plastic, then what happens? I have already elaborated that in hot condition it is very homogeneous, but when it cool down, either it float on the surface or it gets settled in the bottom. So separation is there, separation of polymer from bitumen phase. So how do we measure this separation? It is also a very simple test, no special equipment is required. We take the aluminium tube of one diameter, length 5.5 inch. We seal the one end of the tube, another end is open. So we pour polymer modified binder in hot condition. In that tube, we fill it and we keep in the vertical condition, this tube, at 163 degrees Celsius plus minus 5 degrees Celsius in an oven for 24 hours plus minus 4 hours. Then we freeze it in a freezer at minus 6.7 plus minus 5 degrees Celsius in a vertical position for 4 hours to solidify the sample. First, the sample was very hot at 163 degrees Celsius. Then immediately it was cooled in the freezer to get it freeze, solidify. And then we have cut the tube in three equal fractions. Middle portion we have rejected. Top and bottom portion we have taken. And we have measured the softening point or penetration, one property of the top and bottom portion. We see what happens to the results. This is the schematic representation of phase separation test. It is a tube. Middle portion white is rejected, top portion that is A and bottom portion that is B, these are taken for the testing purpose. Here we see some of the test results of penetration of top and bottom portion. So the separation difference is not much. In case of SBS, top value is 50, bottom value is 51. In case of EVA, it is a polymer, 50-50, so no phase separation. Then in case of LDPE, top portion 58 penetration, bottom portion 57. Similarly, we have taken number of polymers we have tested in the lab to find out whether the phase separation is there, homogeneity of the mixture is there or not. So this test is very important when we talk about polymer modified bitumen. Separation test. Another terminology for the same test is storage stability. How long we can storage such type of binder? If phase separation is not there, we can storage for a longer period. If phase separation is there, we have to use it immediately after production. Then viscosity is very important. So the terminology, suppose we use PMB 120, PMB 70, PMB 40, then what should be the viscosity values in such type of binders? It is given in the POES, 1 to 3 POES, 2 to 6 POES, 3 to 9 POES. So everything is defined in our specification. Viscosity at 150 degrees Celsius is important when we talk about the modified binder. But we talk about conventional VG grade bitumen, then viscosity at 60 degree and 135 degree is important. So we should know the difference about the test temperature of these two type of binders. Now, flexural fatigue life. This is also a laboratory test. We cast a beam, size is given here 200 mm into 37.6 millimeter into 37.6 millimeter. So length, width and height. This test is carried out at 25 degrees Celsius with the repeated loading machine. So repeated fixed loading, fixed load is there, that is applied repeatedly on the specimen on a beam, and we find out the after how many number cycles of repeated loading this beam fails. So with 80-100 bitumen, 60-70 with variety of polymers, SBS, EVA, with different percentage, 2%, 5%, 10%, we have measured this flexural fatigue life. And here we can see the highest cycles sustained by a beam is A plus 5% SBS, that is 91,000 cycles. So SBS is one of the best polymer to modify, polymer modified, to have polymer modified bitumen. Other polymers are also good. If we compare with them 80-100 penetration grade bitumen and 60-70 grade penetration bitumen, number of cycles sustained by modified binders are always more. Now, what is the global scenario when we talk about the polymer modified bitumen? Modifiers as an individual or as a group of materials, we can use more than one modifier at a time. It is not necessary that single modifier will work. More than two modifiers can be put together to produce modified binder. So modifiers as an individual or as a group of materials have made successful path into the road and other construction industries in advanced countries. This is the percentage is being used with different elastomer type of polymer in advanced countries, 75% SBS, SBR and SIS. Plastomer modified 15% only, and other miscellaneous rubber type of modified binders 10%. What is the Indian scenario? Where are we when we talk about India regarding polymer modified bitumen? So as far as laboratory research is concerned, in India, in CRRI, Central Road Research Institute, in Flexible Pavement Division, we have initiated this laboratory research in 1980s. Since then, number of polymer and rubber modifier were investigated in the laboratory for their feasibility of using for hot mix as well as cold mix applications. Now, these are some names we have evaluated in our laboratory. Again, LDPE, low density polyethylene, ethylene vinyl acetate, styrene butadiene styrene, gilsonite resin, natural rubber, polybutadiene rubber, alvaloy AM, JSR Rodex, plastic waste, and Novofault. Siloflex, these are the commercial name because polymer are being produced by the commercial at commercial level by some firms. So they give their own name, Siloflex, Starflex, Crumb Tire Rubber, then TBM Super. So this is also a tire rubber modified bitumen, TBM Super, treated crumb rubber. All these are the chemical name or commercial name of these modifiers. So among all these modifiers, some of the modifiers are added directly to bitumen to produce polymer modified bitumen. But some of them, they are not mixed with bitumen. They are not dispersed in bitumen. So what to do with those type of polymers? We directly add them to the aggregate, then we add bitumen. So first we make aggregate modified with the polymer, and then bitumen is added. So there are two ways to add polymer, directly to bitumen or indirectly with the aggregate. There are several companies, because once we have the polymer modified binder in the laboratory tested, then someone should come forward. They should produce it at commercial level. Then only these can be used in the field. So these are some of the companies. They have taken patent, they have produced at commercial level, and it has been used for road application. Now some of the polymer are in emulsion form. Neither they are solid nor they are like powder, but they are in the polymer emulsion form. So these type of polymer are polymer and rubber emulsion are not mixed with bitumen directly. Why? Because there is 60% solid and 30 to 40% water in polymer emulsions. So if we add them directly in hot bitumen, then water will evaporate, and it is not safe to add cold emulsion into hot bitumen. Accident may happen. So in those cases, what we do? We add polymer emulsion in bitumen emulsion. We modify bitumen emulsion with polymer emulsion to have modified binder. Then we make the cold application in microsurfacing. Microsurfacing is one of the technique where polymer modified emulsion, bitumen emulsion is used, not the conventional bitumen emulsion. So for such type of applications, we can use the liquid polymers or polymer emulsions. Now, some of the polymer are reactive. Some are only dispersed in the bitumen. They are not reactive polymers. They just lying in the bituminous phase. They act as the reinforcing agent. They give strength to the phase. But some of the polymer, commercial name is alvaloe. They are chemically reactive. And when they are adding in a small quantity, 1 to 1.5% only, they in the presence of a catalyst, that is superphosphoric acid, there is a chemical bonding between the polymer and bitumen, and that acts very fast and very good bonding between polymer and bitumen and aggregate. So it gives better performance than conventional bitumen when subjected to elastic recovery, aging, adhesion, indirect tensile and Marshall stability test. We get the better properties as compared to the other polymers. Then one very promising candidate in the polymers is plastic waste. Such type of waste, being thermoplastic in nature, are easily compatible with bitumen. But dealing with plastic waste is more complicated because quality of the waste available in the open market is not consistent. So from the municipal solid waste, we have to take plastic waste. So plastic waste quality and quantity vary in the municipal composition waste. That's why the properties cannot be fixed of this plastic waste. So it varies from source to source. So due to this reason, the more work could not be done, field application I mean to say. Laboratory research has been done all over India. In South, they have constructed few thousand kilometer roads with the help of plastic waste. But in Northern region, in Shimla, I came to know that plastic polythene bags are banned. In some other states also, they have simply banned the plastic polythene bags instead of finding a solution of using them for road construction. Though technologies are available, but there is a need to propagate the technology and to actually bring into the practice the use of plastic waste for road construction. Second limitation is specifications are not available for plastic waste modifier. So it is very difficult in the market, their acceptability. No one want to take risk without the guidelines, when the guidelines are not available of using anything. But CRRI has carried out research on plastic waste modified bitumen using carry bags, poly bags, some mixed plastic waste like cups and other plastic from CRRI and other places. So laboratory studies indicated better performance of plastic waste modified bitumen than conventional binder in terms of their physical properties, mechanical strength and fatigue life, fatigue behavior. So another modifier is the crumb rubber powder from waste tire rubber. There are two methods of producing rubber powder from discarded tire. One is the grinding the tire at ambient temperature, and second one is the cryogenic method. Cryogenic method is very costly. The process is being done at minus 140 degree Celsius temperature, so it is a costly method. But grinding at ambient temperature, it is a labor oriented method. And in our country, we have a lot of labor, so labor is not a problem. So we are getting this crumb rubber powder by grinding method. But in advanced countries like USA, they are more rely on the machinery, not on the labor. So by cryogenic method, they produce their crumb rubber from the waste tire. There is some difference between the rubber surface, rubber particles obtaining by grinding at room temperature or cryogenically ground in liquid nitrogen. So these are some differences. Therefore, the end application or end result of the product will also be different. How we can incorporate this plastic, this crumb rubber powder or waste plastic with bituminous mixes? One is the dry process or dry method. Another is the wet method. So in wet method, I have already told that we will take plastic waste powder or crumb rubber powder or polymer. We will mix it with bitumen. So this is known as wet method. But in dry method, we will directly add it to aggregate. Then we will coat it with bitumen. So this is the only difference using by dry method and wet method. Then TBM Super is the commercial name of the crumb rubber. One company, they have processed crumb rubber in their own methodology, and they give the some commercial name, commercial purpose, TBM Super. It is chemically modified crumb rubber. So it is also used for preparing crumb rubber modified binder, just like LDPE modified binder. So this is the process or methodology given here. What should be the temperature, what should be the time when we talk about the crumb rubber modified binder, especially TBM Super. These are some of the properties, advantages when we talk about the crumb rubber modified binder. Then apart from the laboratory studies, field trials, where we have applied our laboratory research into the field. So in today's context, if I talk, our Prime Minister always talk from lab to land. So whatever technology we develop in our laboratory, it should be applicable to the field. So when we talk about the field application, we have laid many test sections using these LDPE, EVA, SBS and crumb rubber. First section was laid on National Highway number 2 under the ministry project, Kanpur-Varanasi Road, with these modifiers in 1993, long back. That section was monitored for 5 years by CRRI and nothing happened. After that, it was left and further monitoring was not done. 5 years are good enough because on National Highway, the life of the road with conventional bitumen is not more. So if a road works up to 5 years, it is good enough. This is some data about the crumb rubber modified binder. Nothing to discuss much because I have left with the specification also. Performance indicator, how do we monitor the performance of modified mixes? Marshall stability is one parameter we carry out for conventional mixes. We can carry out for modified mixes also. We can compare the properties, Marshall stability, for both type of mixes. Then indirect tensile strength, stiffness modulus, fatigue behavior, wheel tracking test for rutting behavior, and so on. So many test parameters are there which can be determined in the laboratory to find out the performance of modified and unmodified binders. This is some graph between roughness and duration, or this is the life of the road. So roughness, we can see it is not much deteriorated when we talk about CRMB modified binder as compared to conventional binder road. Then another test track was laid on National Highway number 3 near Bombay, State Highway 45 near Joshimath Badrinath Road, Manali Kullu Road, Hindustan Tibet Road near Shimla. So these are the locations where we have tried to apply these binders and to find out the actual performance in the field. Then crumb rubber test section was laid on National Highway number 1 near Ambala and Ring Road opposite Rajghat in Delhi. So these two test sections were laid in 1999. I was the project leader of these two test sections, so I was very much involved from the beginning, and we monitored these sections for 7 years. In Delhi, till 7 years, we have not allowed PWD to give in the overlay. We have requested them that this is our section, kindly, it does not require any overlay, it is in sound condition, so we have monitored and they have agreed. After 7 years, we left the road to PWD and they have overlaid it. Then with the help of natural rubber modified bitumen, test sections were laid in Trivandrum and Ring Road, Delhi also. Then with ethylene terpolymer, test section was laid on Jaipur Agra Road and this Goa airfield. Airport also was constructed with modified binder roads with Elvaloy AM. This is a commercial name, with DuPont polymer. DuPont is an imported firm, we know, outside firm, and it has produced this special polymer for modification of bitumen. Then when we talk about the performance, I have already told you that maintenance period of 12 years on a national highway with heavy traffic, 2 renewal quotes will be enough instead of 3. As required in the existing specification. So we are saving a lot, saving the cost of one maintenance cycle. Then the use of stress absorb membrane interlayer modified between old surface and new surface. The life of the road increased by 2 to 3 years. The cost of periodic maintenance may be reduced by 20 to 30% with polymer modified binders. This is a condition of the road, polymer modified binder road constructed with the help of CRRI, monitored by CRRI. So we can skip some of the points. Now blending of PMB and CRMB with bitumen, either it should be done at site or at hot mix plant. This was a debate, and ultimately in our guidelines it was said that whether you blend it at site, you blend it at hot mix plant, but certain properties one has to achieve as per the specifications, as per the guidelines. Then a strict supervision of during construction with PMB. Why? Because a higher temperature is required, 10 to 15 degree higher temperature is required for manufacturing of the mix, application of the mix, laying and then compaction when we talk about the modified binders. While not cure all the drawbacks of the bitumen, modifier if carefully selected and applied have capacity to extend pavement service life. Now, how do we know that a polymer modified binder produced by a producer at hot mix plant, it is good or bad? So guidelines are there in our Indian code, IRC SP53. First guideline came in 1999. Then these were revised in 2002 and again in 2010 by IRC. And BIS also in 2004, BIS, Bureau of Indian Standard, also issued some guidelines on modified binders. What are these guidelines? That I will discuss in few slides now. These guidelines deal with the use of polymer and rubber modified bitumen in road construction, their advantages, type, indicative dose, and precautions needed during their use. Now, specifications, application, choice of appropriate grade of binder, handling at site are also given in these guidelines. Broad range of temperature prevailing at different construction site, method of test for phase separation and elastic recovery, and modulus. These two, three methods, procedures are also included in these guidelines, because these methods are not available in for bitumen, conventional bitumen. So separately they have given the procedure in these guidelines. The quality of modifier are determined by test on bitumen, modified bitumen, and bituminous mixes. So if we want to know whether my modifier or modified bitumen works well, then I have to carry out test of neat bitumen, modified bitumen, then bituminous mixes. Some products are proprietary item of a company. So in case of proprietary product, test report and cost effectiveness should be the basis of the selection of such type of product. So these are the doses and type of the bitumen modifiers. For example, plastic and thermoplastic, low density polyethylene, EVA, EBA epoxy. These are 3 to 6% only sufficient to modify the bitumen. Elastomers, natural rubber, synthetic rubber, other elastomer, 2 to 4% are enough for modification purpose. But in case of tire rubber powder, 10 to 12% tire crumb rubber powder is required to modify the binder. So there are some terminology used in case of plastomer modified and elastomer modified bitumen. In 2004-2002, the terminology was different, but in the latest specification I will show you how the polymer modified binders are designed and elaborated. Now how do we select the PMB, in which temperature range what PMB grade should be used? So there is a table given in our code of practice. If the maximum atmospheric temperature is less than 35 and minimum pavement temperature is less than minus 10, then the grades are given. These type of grades you can select for those typical climatic condition and temperature. These are the latest guidelines which we are now using for modified binders. So there are certain tests, penetration, opening point, frost breaking point, flash point, and the test value are also given. The range are given for different grade of polymer modified binder. What should be the test value one should obtain in the laboratory to find the quality of the modified binder. And the highest mean air temperature, lowest mean air temperature are the criteria for selection of a modified binder for a typical climatic condition. This is also given in our guidelines. Then elastic recovery, which is one of the important parameter in case of modified binder, these are also given. Minimum 50, 60 and 60 for three different type of grades of polymer modified bitumen. Then separation difference, as I have already elaborated, that penetration value of top and bottom portion, it should not differ. Here the softening point value is given. Softening point value of top and bottom portion after the phase separation test, it should not be more than 3. So 3 is the criteria. Then viscosity also, it is given for all 3 grades, 1 to 3 PoS at 150 degrees Celsius, 3 to 6 and 5 to 9. So these are also essential to be achieved. Then similarly, thin film moment test for aging purpose of the, what is the extent of aging of such type of modified binders, the thin film moment test is being carried out, and the limits are given in our specifications. Then when we talk about the design of the bituminous mixes, the Marshall method, whatever is the conventional method that is being used to produce modified binder mixes, and the test properties achieved should be according to the climatic condition. For hot climatic condition, cold climatic condition and high rainfall areas, the Marshall stabilities should be at 60 degrees Celsius, it should be minimum 1200, 1000 and 1200 for different type of climatic condition. Similarly, the Marshall flow, Marshall quotient, these are the given for such type of modified mixes. Voids in the mix, 3 to 5%, as usual we get in the conventional bitumen mixes. Then requirement of the retained stability after 24 hours dipped in water at 60 degrees Celsius, the retained stability should be as high as 90, 95 and 100 according to the climatic condition. Coating with aggregate is also one of the parameter which should be judged in the guidelines, according to the guidelines. Then what should be the binder content? Because when we talk about the polymer modified binder, it's a new material for the field application. So when we float a company, PWD or NHAI, they want to float a tender, then how they can do that? So minimum binder content, optimum binder content, minimum is given for BC, SDBC and DBM. So on the basis of this minimum requirement, one can float the binder and go ahead with the construction of with modified binders. Handling of the modified bituminous mixes, modifier should be thoroughly blended with bitumen, phase separation should not be there. Different type of modifier require different techniques of blending. Storage stability is important. Blended bitumen should be supplied in tanker, and if supplied in the drum, it shall be agitated in hot condition with suitable device for 10 to 15 minutes before they are used. Penetration, opening point, separation and elastic recovery test shall be carried out at site for a lot of 5-ton batch. Then these are the viscosity for different stages of work, what viscosity should be achieved at what temperature. These are very important for workability of the this modified binder and their handling. Controls, some controls are required until and unless manufacturer or supply indicate any special condition for using, we can use them as we use for conventional bitumen. Then various tests required, these are the various tests required for the conventional binder and modified polymer modified binder. We can see the no extra equipment is required, only very available infrastructure, whatever we are using in the present contest with the conventional binder, this is sufficient to judge the performance of modified binders also. So these are some of the data with me, what is the extended life with when we talk about the polymer bitumen binder. So nothing much to say. With all these, I will have some photographs of the my laboratory, thin film oven test and other this fatigue test, etc. So with some testing in the field also we have done. When we constructed the road with polymer modified binder, Benkelman beam, normal apparatus, normal equipment as we do performance for our roads. This is the BI for roughness purpose. So with all these, I will thank you, all of you, for patiently hearing, and thanks to Professor Duggal inviting me at this forum. Thank you very much.